Hello, my student. Your physics teacher, Sandra Lewis, with you. In this video, I'm going to solve an example about the diffraction of light. Let's start. A laser beam of wavelength 633 nanometers falls normally on a slit of width A equals 0.24 millimeters. Diffraction patterns are observed on a screen 6 meters away from the plane of the slit. Part A. Define and calculate the angular width. Part B. Determine the width of the central bright fringe. First, what is meant by the angular width? In reality, the angular width, call it alpha, is the angle that suspends the central bright fringe. Here, for example, is the screen of observation, and here is the central bright fringe. You know that the central bright fringe is surrounded by the first two dark fringes. Here, the first dark fringe, m equal 1, and here is also the first dark fringe, but in the negative side, m equal minus 1. We call this, let's say, y prime or y, oriented positively upward. Here is A, okay? You know that laser beam coming from behind the slit passes through the narrow slit and diffracts. Now I'm going only to look here at the central bright fringe. Here is the angular width alpha. This is angle alpha. And this angle alpha, you know, is double the angle theta. Here is angle theta. Let me call it theta 1, corresponding to m equal 1. Okay? So you know, there is only one rule in this lesson, which is called single slit diffraction formula. Sine theta, sine theta equals m lambda over A. Now because theta is this small angle, so theta less than 10 degrees, we are allowed to write sine theta approximately equal to theta. So theta equals m lambda over A. Okay? But I want angle theta to correspond to the first dark fringe, m equal to 1. So implies theta 1 equal lambda over A. Right? Angle alpha, you see here, angle alpha is double angle theta. So alpha equal 2 theta 1, which is equal to 2 lambda over A. And this is always the case, okay? You will always get alpha equal to 2 lambda over A. Now, by substitution, if you substitute the numbers, then you get alpha equal 0.0053, almost 0.0053 radian, which is very small angle. less than 1 degree. That's part A. Now part B. In part B, determine the width of the central bright fringe. Now, let's look at the central bright fringe. Here it is. Here is the central bright fringe, and I want to calculate its width. Okay, here it is. You remember the diffraction, let me call it L. You remember the diffraction pattern. Let me look at the diffraction pattern. Here it is. This is the central bright fringe. And here is the width L. This is L. Okay? So I want to calculate its value. So L. But remember, we call this Y. And I'm going the ordinate of any dark fringe. I call Y1 corresponding to the first dark fringe. You remember? We use the right angle, the triangle. Tangent. Theta is equal, as a rule, opposite over adjacent. Now, let me call the adjacent D, which is 6 meters in this example. 6 meters. Okay? So, tangent theta is Y over D. And theta small, theta small angle means less than 10 degrees. We can say theta equal tangent to theta, and consequently theta equal y, let me call it theta 1, corresponding to the first part range, equal y1 over d. Now here, theta 1 lambda over a, and theta 1 is y1 over d. Theta 1 equals theta 1, theta equals theta, like y1 equals lambda d over a. But look, the width of the central bright fringe is double y1, because here y1 and here y1. So it implies L equals 2 lambda d over a. And if you do the calculation, of course, transform to a side unit, you get almost 0.032 meters. Okay?